exceptions, and I'm not a leader. Think in the box and I get in my fix, the shot is empty. I'll be the donor hole.
Now under the dome tonight, MLB The Show has baseball from Tropicana Field. Tonight, an exciting interleague matchup of first-place clubs between the Washington Nationals and the Tampa Bay Rays. It's Rays baseball, and it starts right now. Tyler Glasnow, the California-born right-hander, is on the mound. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Two words, Matt. High ceiling. This guy has a chance to be one of the most dominant pitchers in all of baseball. Big, tall, strong guy with a big power arm and a nasty hammer curveball. If he's throwing strikes with his fastball and his curveball, he's nearly impossible to hit.
Striding in is Trey Turner. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. Fielded cleanly, and he'll step on first for the out, three unassisted.
John Johnston is narrative. Streaming MLB The Show 2-1, Nationals versus Rays 6-8-2-1.
DH in this interleague matchup.
Yeah, Matt, that's one of the funny things about National League teams playing in AL ballparks. All of a sudden, the lineup kind of changes dramatically. But the cool thing is it gives more guys a chance to get some at-bats or time in the field.
1-1 the count now. Now here it comes. Fastball called strike, 1-2.
Well-executed fastball right at the knees. Going to be a long day for this offense if he stays in that spot.
And a big curveball is in there for a called third strike, and there are two gone.
Big curveball from the strikeout there, and that came after an absolute missile of a fastball. Even if you recognize the breaking ball out of the pitcher's hand, it's so hard for hitters to sit back long enough after they've seen a really good fastball. Only the best can keep their hands back on those.
Two out, nobody on. Now a fastball that's taken close that time, but it's 1-1. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
Scooped up. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for Washington. And now the Rays will get their first opportunity in a scoreless ball game. Joe Ross will be on the mound for the series opener. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, Matt, we're getting a chance to look at a guy that's really struggled lately. ERA over 5 in his last 3 starts, so he's going to have to really improve on that one. Too many base runners, too many hits, and too many walks. He needs to get off to a good start and maybe throw up a 0 in the first inning.
Brett Phillips will bat next. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Brett.
And the pitch.
Off the plate, ball one.
So, guys, these Nationals, as they enter play here tonight, they come in looking to turn things around as they've dropped 2 straight.
Yeah, Matty, you never know right here. Interleague game. When the weather gets cold, this could be a nice harbinger to what we're going to see in the Fall Classic right here. Two first-place teams going to lock horns in a battle, and I'm jacked up.
No offer at that one. It's a cold strike. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here.
That's a great sinker right there. These batters are going to have to bear down, because if he's got that good pitch working, it's going to be a long game. They might have to sit off speed.
So it was a swinging strike 3. Brett Phillips sent packing to begin the bottom of the inning.
Yandy.
So now here is Yandy Diaz. First pitch on its way.
Nope, that's down.
The windup and the 1-0 pitch.
2 balls, no strike.
That's where he wants that sinker to end up, but that was a nice job of laying off.
So let's take a peek at the umpiring crew in this one. Behind the plate is Matthew Ross.
Well, D-Row, you better be ready to swing. With Matt Ross behind the dish, big zone.
Yeah, you know coming into this one, you better pull the trigger. If something's close, Matt Ross is going to punch your ticket. That's what you want the guys at the top of the order to do. Set the table for the monsters. 3-4-5. Nice piece of hit.
Into the box, Brendan Lau, a real threat with the bat, of course, as he currently leads the American League in home runs.
This guy's right in the prime of his career right now. The power bat speaks for itself. One of the more dangerous hitters in the game of baseball.
Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one.
Hey, when you're featuring a mid-90s fastball like this pitcher, attack with that pitch. Get ahead. Get the offense on their toes. That opens up the off-speed pitches later in the game.
A swinging bunt out in front of the plate. And there's out number two.
Batting fourth, the first baseman, G-Man Choi.
G-Man Choi, the next to hit. He was 1-for-4 in Sunday's affair. From the stretch. Well above the letters with the fastball that time.
That's a good take on a fastball out of the zone. Hey, I get it. He's looking for a ball to drive, but that ball was a little bit too far up in the zone. That's one you normally pop right up.
Throw on the belt first, and the side is retired. One left for Tampa, and this is still a nothing-nothing ball game. Now at the plate is Josh Bell. He'll get us started in the top of the second. Here's the first pitch.
Hey, love the pitcher attacking the zone right here. He knows he's got a patient hitter at the plate. Might as well steal that first strike.
Grounded back up the middle. He's got it. On the first, and there's one gone here to start the second.
That is good. The second baseman, Starling Castro.
So here's Starling Castro. And as you take a look at the splits, right-handed pitching this season. And now the first pitch. And here's a fastball called for strike one. His previous meeting line with Tyler Glasnow. He's 1-for-3. Grounded to short. Adames picks it up. Throw on to first, two gone.
That is good.
Bases are empty here with two away, and that'll bring up the left-handed hitting Kyle Schwarber. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. No score here as we play inning number two. Just a bit late, and he's fallen behind 0-2. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact.
You know, he's had a very economical start out there. Got through the first inning on just 9 pitches. And he's got a chance to keep it in single digits again here in the second.
Now another 1-2. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Bases are empty here with two men out. And now a pitch that ties him up as he has to fight to stay alive as this is pushed foul. Swing and a miss at a big breaking ball, and that's how the inning comes to an end. Nationals gone in order. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. At the plate now is Willy Adames, who was 1-for-3 in the ball game back on Sunday. First pitch on the way.
What a well-executed fastball right there, down and away. If you're going to do any damage with that pitch, you have to think up the middle the other way, and you have to be diving and leaning out over that thing.
Behind 0-2 now. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down. And now in the box, Randy Arozarena. And he's got that batting lineup near the 300 mark entering play. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. Sinker to open the AB, and there for strike one.
I can't imagine that pitcher was trying to put it right over the heart of the plate. Thank God he took that pitch right there. He'd be getting one back from the umpire.
Count now a ball and a strike. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Sliced hard on the ground. And that'll find its way into right field for a one-out single.
Yeah, he's going to have to work that sinker down the zone. That's his bread and butter pitch, and if he's going to leave that belt high, that's going to spell disaster.
Mike Brosseau digging into the plate as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. He'll start this one at 269. Five homers and 11 RBIs. Fly ball out toward left center field. Left fielder is on the move. He gets there, and that's the second out. Here now is Mike Zunino. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. Pitch on its way now to Zunino. And he'll hold off on the slider here to start the at-bat. It's ball one. A Rosarena, a runner at first with two gone. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact.
You thank your lucky stars when you get a chance to hit behind a guy with as much speed as he has on first base. The entire defense is on guard, and you know probably there's a fastball coming.
A swing and a drive to center field. That one's got a chance. And he will get there as he had to cover a lot of ground to make that play. And that ends the inning. The love of the game runs deep with these folks. Don't go anywhere. More Tuesday Night Baseball after this. Here's the catcher, Yan Gomes. He's the number seven hitter, but he's leading off the third after the first six guys in the lineup have been retired in order.
Yeah, it's been a great start to the guy on the mound. It'll be interesting to see if they can find a way to get to this guy before he really settles in.
Weak grounder back to the mound. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. One away now in the Washington third, and the ever-versatile Josh Harrison digs in. On the ground to the right side, reined in. And very quickly there, they're two gone to start the inning. Victor Robles digging in now, and there's a look at his Pullman Road splits so far this year. He's set, here it comes.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice...
Well, the side is retired as they make the play. Three up, three down for Washington. Half of the third coming up. No score. Matt Vasgersian back with Mark DeRozan and Dan Plesac as Kevin Kiermaier settles in to start the inning.
Kiermaier.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Kevin Kiermaier is in to start things off here as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one. Down the first bit. Oh, and it's off the first base bag. And they won't get an out from this as he's able to reach on a play that you just don't see very often.
So frustrating, Giro. You make a good pitch and you get these guys that can run around and they're fast. You think you have an out and all of a sudden it turns into an infield single.
Yeah, this is definitely part of his game, the ground attack, Dan. He's a speedster. He's going to get a ton of infield singles and he knows how frustrated that pitcher is.
Stepping in now, Brett Phillips, as he takes a cold strike at the knees. It's 0-1. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Ready with the 0-1. And he's way off balance with the swing there.
good speed at first and good speed with a guy at the dish. It's going to be tough to double up these guys. If you're an infielder, you got to get rid of it quick.
Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. And a check swing here, but the bat clearly breaks the plane as he set down for the first out.
Always tough for one of these base umpires to make a call on a guy's check swing. It's not a great angle, and everything happens so quickly, so they really have to be paying attention out there. Looking at the replay, I think he got it right, so that's a tip of the cap for the Blue.
Yandy Diaz comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. Bottom of inning number three, nothing our score. Kiermaier's running. Pitch inside the throw. Short hop, but they got him. Great pick and tag to catch him trying to steal.
Wow, that's a big-time throw right there. And it's a tall task to throw him out stealing a back. But he got rid of it quickly, and it was a good job down there applying the quick tag. They'll have to feel good about that
one. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. 1-2. Swung on and missed, strike three. Nothing doing for Tampa. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. Here now is Trey Turner back to the top of the lineup as they're still looking for their first base runner in this one.
No doubt about that, man. They've yet to figure this guy out on the mound. He's looked great so far.
He has, but we'll see if this second trip through the order changes anything.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments these hitters are able to make in the middle innings of this game.
And while we have a moment, here's a look at the Rays Road to the Show report. Two guys there that this organization has to be happy about right now. Into the box, Luis Garcia. He grounds it sharply to third. And there's the first hit of the game for the Nats.
Boy, Dero, the game of baseball has changed. There's so much velocity in the game. That was a 96-mile-an-hour fastball that he smoked the other way.
Yeah, you have to keep your front shoulder tucked right there. You have to honor. When a guy's throwing that hard, 96 miles an hour, you have to honor that fastball and try and work it the other way to keep you on the off speed.
Juan Soto will stand in for the second time now as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one. No runs, just one hit, and no errors so far for the Nationals. That's taken. Now it's 0-2. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
Pitching 1-1 is changing location and upsetting the hitter's timing. You do that, and everything's going to be fine. And that strikeout, he never threw the same pitch twice in a row, and he won the battle because of it.
Josh Bell the next to hit. 0-1 the count. Garcia is off of first with two away. In there, and it's 0-2 now.
There's another pitch for a strike, and this guy's really attacking hitters well tonight, being aggressive early on. And if he continues to throw strikes like he is, he's going to have a pretty good night.
Now he drops a changeup on him. Strike three called, and a great pitch there to retire the side. The Nationals lead one. On to the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score. Stepping in once again is Brandon Lowe, set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
I know we're not seeing a lot of offense in this one, but there's still some game left. I'm looking to see these guys, both offenses, make some notable adjustments at the dish and try and scratch a few runs across.
They haven't played perfectly as it's hit on the ground. Gloved by Castro, and a good throw gets him one gone. One out here in the Tampa Bay fourth, and that brings up the corner infielder G-Man Choi. First offering on its way.
Man, this pitcher is on right now, pounding the zone, attacking these hitters. He's making it look easy.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Here's a breaking ball outside, and now it's even 1-1. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number 4. Swing and a liner. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
Nothing fires me up more than watching a hitter take what a pitcher gives him. Pitches away, batter's able to keep his hands inside, not try and do too much, and just force feed a single.
So now to the plate, Willie Adames, as he will take a fastball in there at the knees for strike one.
Man, this guy's been incredibly efficient so far in this one. Mostly because he's getting ahead. 70% of the batters he's faced, he's thrown a first pitch strike to.
And he lays off for ball one. And this is on the ground to short. Could be two. Zips it to Castro for one. Relay to Bell. The double play. And that's how the inning ends. Rays held in check here. Through four, still tied, nothing. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Nationals manager Dave Martinez between innings, specifically about his club's offense to this point.
And he was pretty blunt in saying they're just not having very good at-bats. They've only managed one base runner in this game, so it's easy to see why he said they haven't shown much fight today. He's hoping to see someone step up and find a way to get something going, though. This game isn't out of hand, so it remains to be seen if they can snap out of this funk and climb back into this one.
All right, Heidi, thank you.
The second baseman.
Here's Starlin Castro. Comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. In there, strike one.
Great pitch right there. That is a huge breaking ball. Not shocked he took it. Got to calibrate that one for a second.
A Rosarena is over a few steps as he puts it away for the first out. One gone for the Nationals in the fifth. And next, it'll be the left-handed power threat, Kyle Schwarber. Called a strike on the outer half, 0-1. One out, nobody on. And it's quickly 0-2. Fouled away. Here comes another 0-2. And it's belted high and deep into right center. Back goes Kiermaier, still ranging back. Gone! That one's swimming with the Rays. A solo home run for Kyle Schwarber. Home run number 5 on the year. As the Nationals strike first, it's 1-0.
I can tell you one thing. You might get away with throwing a ball in that location in the minor leagues, but when you get one up like that in the zone right over the plate against these guys, you're going to get exactly what he got, a really bad result.
Into the box now, Yan Gomes. As he'll take a look at an off-speed pitch here that misses for ball one. He's 0-for-1 thus far. And that's right there, and we're even at one. Bases are empty, one man out. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. 3-1 to Yan Gomes.
If I'm in the box right now, I'm coming unglued. He is going to throw something over the heart of the plate.
Heading out towards shallow right. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. And now for Washington, Josh Harrison. First pitch on the way.
Ball one, no strike.
Strike taken as the curveball drops into the bottom part of the zone.
Hey, that's just a nice get me over curveball there to steal a strike. I don't think he was looking for that one.
Two balls and a strike now. And he wouldn't have made contact with that one with an oar. It's 2-2.
He's got a good feel for it.
But we'll have to press pause as that strike 3 to retire the side. report first, courtesy of the solo home run. Bottom of the fifth coming up. It's now 1-0 Washington. We're back at Tropicana Field, and let's check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, Rays manager Kevin Cash talked to me in between innings about his lineup's offensive production. And one thing he mentioned to me was the lack of discipline he's seeing out of their at-bats right now. He said their pitch selection has been the main reason for their struggles today, as far too often they've been swinging at pitches outside the strike zone. That's leading to a lot of soft contact and easy outs. So the focus going forward is on shrinking the zone and forcing the opposing pitching to throw more strikes.
Leading off.
Thank you, Heidi.
The white field.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Randy Arozarena is at the plate here as he quickly finds himself down a strike. It's 0-1.
He hasn't thrown that pitch much all game. I got to believe as an offense, you just got to throw that pitch away and move on to the next one.
And the throw by Castro takes care of him for the first down. Up next, Michael Brasso. He flew out in his... Pitch on the way. There's a strike at the knees, 0-1. No runs, four hits, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. Bullet back up the middle. Robles is there now, and he has it, two gone.
Now back, the catcher. Mike.
Next, it'll be Mike Zunino. Flew out last time up. Pitch on its way now to Zunino.
Nope, outside.
Two out, nobody on. Can't sit back long enough, and the count evens up at 1-1. Now here it comes. A little bouncer.
Man, he's in control of all his weapons right here. One strike away from five shutout innings.
Strike three called as he can't get the bat off his shoulders. Side retired. Down in order go the Rays. They trail this one 1-0. Now to the plate. Here is Victor Robles. Match up with Tyler Glasnow to lead off the inning. From the stretch, here's the pitch.
He's struggling to find the release point of that curveball. That wasn't a very good one. Somehow he's just got to find that feel, because that's a pitch he's going to need going forward.
2-0 to the National center fielder.
Not even close with the 1-0. He needs to get back in the zone, but be careful. Work the quadrants.
I got 2-1. On the count.
One of my pet peeves in the game. 1-0, 2-0, 3-1.
Three balls.
You're all over the heater. How are you late on that fastball?
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Curveball got him swinging for the first down.
He's racking up a fair amount of strikeouts now out there. That's sixth at this point. So he's got good stuff, and he's fooling a lot of these hitters.
Speedy Trey Turner digs in now as the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike. One out, nobody on. Now a swing and a deep drive to left, and it ain't coming back. And gone, an absolute bomb. Trey Turner with a solo shot. Seven home runs for him on the year now. And the Nationals move out in front here 2-0.
Baseball has really changed. Remember when leadoff guys were guys that would just draw walks and steal bases? But that's not the case anymore. Guys like this, they have pop in their bat, and they can go deep.
Standing in now, Luis Garcia, as the first pitch to him is a changeup that can't find the zone. It's ball one. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Looked like he went around that time. They'll appeal down to third, and yes, sir, it's strike one. The 1-1 home.
Nope, outside.
Bases are empty, one man out. Swing and a liner. And that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit.
Wow, I'm shocked he even pulled the trigger on that pitch. He might have been fooled right there, but he was able to keep his hands back and scramble a good pitch for a base hit.
Juan Soto to the plate now. As he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. Cold strike on the outside part of the plate, 0-2.
Your idea of working the count goes out the window. You're frustrated right now, down 0-2. Got to find a way to grind.
Hits are now even at four apiece. Drilled to first. And he'll take this over to the bag for the out, but meanwhile, the runner moves into scoring position at second.
Here's one that you don't see too often, right? Safe at second base, but out at first. Great hustle there from the runner going into second. Really showed off his speed.
So that'll bring up Josh Bell. Lifted down the line and left. Heading after it is Phillips. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. Nationals able to add on thanks to the long ball. Bottom of the sixth coming up. It's 2-0 Washington. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And that means Kevin Kiermaier will hit next.
Kevin Kiermaier.
Now the pitch. Pitch to the plate is a sinker for a called strike. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1.
Ball, that's out.
One and two.
One ball.
I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's his windup. I don't know if it's just flat stuff. But he's getting a lot of swings outside the zone, and he's having a big game.
And the throw will indeed take care of him for the first out.
Now batting. Let's
go. Next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Brett Phillips. He went down on strikes last time up.
Yeah, and he didn't put up much of a fight either, Matty. Got to find a way. Can't go down three pitches. I don't care if you're staring at him or swinging at him. You have to find a way to make this pitcher work a little bit harder.
Now one and a fastball here, not close, and it's 1-1 now. Hit Wheatley back to the mound. And there are two away now. And that will bring in Yandy Diaz. One for two with a base hit back in the first inning. Here it comes. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1.
Don't expect too many more high fastballs in this one. He is known for his sinker, keeping the ball on the ground.
Really dotting the corners here with the fastball. 0-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. And he struck him out. His seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Rays go in order. 1-2-3. They trail things here 2-0. Colin McHugh is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 31, Colin.
Now to the plate, Starlin Castro. He'll start the seventh in what's been a fast-moving pitcher's duel to date. Starts him out with a slider for a strike. Off the plate and in, it's a ball and a strike.
Looked like he was a little over-aggressive there to throw that nasty curveball. Just needs to slow his delivery down a bit.
And that finds the outfield grass for a base hit. And now it'll kick around in the corner. And he's out. trying to stretch it into a double, so a costly mistake here leading off the inning. Kyle Schwarber will stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle innings. This was a turning point here, a solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. First offering. Fouled off. One out, nobody on. Hit down the line at first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Now into the box, Yan Gomes. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. A ball and no strikes. Low and away as he misses again. 2-0. Here's the pitch. And this is lined hard to deep left. And what an effort on the running play to end the inning. Nationals gone in order. They're up 2-0. Last half of the seventh here, and that'll bring in the second base.
The second baseman.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. As anticipated, here's a ground ball now to the right side.
He's
out. Take it to the bag himself for the out. One out now in the Tampa Bay seventh, and that brings up the corner infielder, G-Man Choi. He's ready. Here's the first pitch.
Oh, that's
a couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. The 1-0 home. Now a swing and a deep drive to right. Right fielder looking up, and that one is gone! A solo shot here to straightaway right field. Number 17 for him on the season, and the Rays have cut this to a 2-1 ball game now.
What a great feeling right there as he circles the pillows, finally able to get this offense potentially going with one swing of the bat. Being shut out all game, but not anymore.
At the plate, Willie Adames. Just swing at the first pitch and bang one into right center field. That's a base hit. Well, it took him till the seventh, but he gets his first hit of the game here, and that'll extend his hitting streak.
Yeah, he didn't come out of what he was trying to do all day, Dan. Kept the front shoulder up, kept the ice water in his veins, but didn't try and get too big. Extends the hitting streak. Nice job.
You know, Nero, I talked to him before the game about the streak, and he said the toughest part is he hopes to get hits early in the game to take the pressure off. He had to wait to the seventh inning in this one to come through.
Daniel Hudson will come on in relief now as he'll make his 35th appearance of the season.
Number 44, Daniel Hudson.
Here's Randy Arozarena as he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. He's 1-for-2 in this one. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two.
Like to see him be looking to the opposite field with this next swing. Pitcher's trying to work you away.
Here's Hudson now on 2-0. swung on. Missed 2-1.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
2-1 pitch is a fastball swung on and missed 2-2.
It's becoming more and more common in today's game to see relievers like this that can run it up there close to 100 miles per hour. But it's so fun to watch it. He blew it right by him there.
The 2-2. Swung on and missed strike three.
That's a big strikeout there with the tying run over at first base. Now, with two outs, it becomes a lot more difficult to manufacture that guy home. Probably need a ball in the gap to give him a chance.
To the plate now, Michael Brasso, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. The 0-1 pitch. Got him to go after that one, and he's in a quick hole, 0-2.
That front door slider is a devastating pitch. By the time you realize it's in the zone, it's too late. You can't even put a good swing on it.
Now the 0-2 pitch.
Nope.
Too high. 1-2.
Love the high heater right there to raise the hitter's sights. Let's see if he buries something in the dirt right here.
Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. But not before they answer back here with a solo home run. We'll march on to the eighth. It's the Nationals 2, the Rays 1. Wander Suero has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. New inning set to get underway, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Josh Harrison. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. And a curveball in for a strike. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Kiermaier's got a read on it, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. Next to stand in is Victor Robles. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. And here's a first pitch curveball that bounces on him there. It's ball one.
You know, because this is just a one-run game, this doesn't strike me as a situation where he's going to be working around a guy. I think he's going to challenge him right here.
1-2 now.
1-2.
Our pitcher's duel continues here. 2-1 score as we play the eighth. And this is swung on and missed. Two are quickly retired to start inning number eight.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
Trey Turner stride in one more time as we flash you back to earlier. This was a big blow right here as he leaves the yard with plenty to spare. Set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Hit on the ground toward the left. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit. The relay, the tag, and they'll get him at second. And with that, the side is retired. Three up, three down for Washington. They still lead it 2-1. Will Harris is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 36, Will Harris.
So here's Mike Zunino. Career numbers and against Will Harris. He's gone 2-for-6.
The catcher. Mike Zunino.
And now the first pitch.
Nope, that's a ball.
Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get pushed out there. The 1-0. Zunino, a drive. That's out to deep left field. That one is out of here. This game is tied. A solo shot here to left. And just like that, this ball game is all tied.
Big time at bat right there. Team trailing, and he ties it up with a bomb. Interested to see how this one finishes out.
Now batting, center fielder, Kevin Kiermaier.
Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier. As he'll take the breaking ball too low, and it's 1-0. As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan, D-Row, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage.
Yeah, you know, D-Row, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. And the pitch. Pulled toward right center field. Robles is on his horse. He's there and records the first down. Stepping in next, Brett Phillips. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. First pitch on its way. And he takes a cold strike, 0-1. In there at the knees, 0-2 now.
0-2 is the count.
After falling down 0-2 on the same pitch, don't be shocked if he triples up on it.
Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game.
That was a big strikeout there, guys. The best pitchers have the ability to strike guys out when they really need to. And that second out was really important.
Now, Yandy Diaz. He sends it out to left field. Well hit. But that'll stay in the park as it's off the wall.
Wow, he was willing that thing to get out of here. Would have given him the lead right here late in the game. But it ends up hitting off the wall, and he heads into second with an extra base hit. We'll see if the next man up can come through in the clutch here.
Ready now is Brandon Lau. Been a rough go of things at the plate for him so far, but his guys are looking for him to change that right here.
Yeah, nothing better than coming through for the boys in a tight game, Matt, especially when you're kind of due to do something productive.
Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch.
Count 1-0.
Hey, this one's tied late in the game. As a pitcher right now, you just can't lay a cookie in there 1-0.
1-0. Here it is. Lifts it into the air to shallow center. Turner has a play. He hauls it in, and the potential go-ahead run will not come around to score. Frustration boiling over with an opportunity missed. We're back to St. Pete after a quick word. Oliver Drake will be on the mound to start the ninth inning, and his job will be keeping the ballgame tied until the bottom half. All set to start the ninth in this one. And he's set and the pitch. Swing and a liner. Oh, look at the sliding stop. He's up with it. The throw. Touché, sir. Well, that was certainly worth another look with Showtrack. He made that play look easy, but the sliding stop is anything but. Then he rifles the ball across the infield to complete the out. Just a great play all the way around. Here now is Juan Soto. Swung on, but fouled off to the left. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Line toward the gap in left center. But this will hang up just enough as he takes it in stride in left center for the second out.
I know they say sometimes that these things even out, but that was a bullet line drive that gets caught. He would have represented the go-ahead run.
So now to the plate, Josh Bell. The fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. Lifted the other way down the left field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Again, another foul ball. Two out, nobody on. Another one sent foul. And he strikes him out on a good pitch. So one run can win it as we head to the bottom of the inning. Nationals gone in order. Score remains 2-2. All set for the bottom of the ninth. And next to bat will be the first baseman, G-Man Choi.
In the last at-bat, that breaking ball was really up in the zone. Not a good spot for a pitcher to throw the off-speed pitch. If he wants to come back and throw that in this at-bat, he better get it down below the knees.
Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. Boy, good cutting action to that pitch as that's the first out of the inning. Next to hit, Willie Adames. Career numbers against Will Harris. Not a big sample size, 0-for-1. From the stretch. And it's fouled away. And there's a curveball in the dirt that time for a ball. 1-1. Hit on the ground to short. And that's the second out. Now into the box is Randy Arozarena, struck out in his last trip to the plate. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. He's set. The 0-1.
Ball, that's it.
Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. So they can't get that winning run home, and that means we'll have to go a little longer tonight to find a winner. 10th inning coming up, and we are tied 2-2. Digging in will be Starlin Castro. He'll be the one to lead it off here in the top of inning number 10. Here's the first pitch. Swing and a liner. Quick reactions at the hot corner take away a hit, and there's one gone. Big at bat now, and here is Kyle Schwarber. And the chance they walk him here to set up a double play that will keep the game tied. Ball one to start the at bat. the 1-0.
Yeah!
Well, he's following the code not to miss down and into a lefty. Everything on the outer half of the plate.
And this is taken for a called strike, and he's not in love with that call either. It's 1-2 now. Now here's a comebacker back to the mound. And he'll send it on to first, and that'll freeze the runner at second with two away now. So a runner at second, two down now, and that means the catcher, Yan Gomes, bats next. And a look at a fastball that doesn't miss by a whole lot. It's 1-0. High in the air down the right field line. Long run for the right fielder. Into the corner, he makes the catch to end the inning. Clearly fired up to work out of that jam. A chance to win it now as we head to the bottom of the 10th. Still tied. Luis Avila comes on to start the home 10th, and he's just hoping to get this one into the 11th inning. And now here is Michael Brasso, and he's got a chance.
For the Reds, the third baseman, Michael Brasso.
Here's the first pitch.
1-0.
Now the Nats are going to get a left-hander up and throwing in the bullpen. Got him out on his front foot there as it swung on and missed for strike one. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Robles waits on it. He's got it one away. Chance to walk it off, and now here is Mike Zunino. The winning run stands at second base.
Goes to show you how strong this guy is. That wasn't a bad breaking ball that he hit for a home run that last at bat. That ball was down in a way. He went out and hooked it and pulled it. This guy's definitely a good hitter.
The 0-1.
That was a great take, or he got fooled. He's certainly trying to play it off like he knew what was coming. You could bet he'd be on alert for that curveball again.
Oh, and they pull the string on a good changeup there as he swings and misses, and he's set down on strikes for the second time tonight.
Well, there's the great equalizer. Changeup, El Cambio. Listen, if you can keep that pitch in your back pocket and pull it out when you need it like he did right there, usually hitters, they don't stand a chance.
So here's Kevin Kiermaier. And he'll take a look at ball one. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Perhaps a little low there. It's 2-0. Hit back up the middle. Starlin dives. What a stop. Not in time. If that was anybody else running down the line, he'd have had him. Drops the tag. He got him. Diego Castillo takes the mound to start the 11th inning.
Number 63, Diego.
Josh Harrison stands in. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Here's the first pitch. Looked like the sinker there. Dipped a little below the knees. Pops this one up. In comes Phillips. But he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass. And the go-ahead run will score from second as they've taken the lead here in the late going.
Dan, you'll take RBIs any way you can get them, but when they give your team the lead in the late innings, man, that feels good.
Oh, it especially does, especially when you start to score runs late in the game off of quality pitching. When runs are at a premium, that's one makes you feel really good about yourself.
Victor Robles is at the plate as he watches ball one. Had him lunging at that pitch away, and it's 1-1 now.
He's staring a hat trick in the face right now after that swing.
And now he has some trouble with it in center.
Even though that pitcher was able to execute in off the plate, batter was able to keep his hands inside that baseball and drive it up the middle.
And now Trey Turner. And on the first pitch, he grounds foul. He's got two hits in four at-bats. 0-1, here it comes. And he fouls this one off. 0-2 once more.
You know, taking you inside the mind of a batter right here, you can't get in auto swing mode. You still have to control the strike zone.
So we got him looking there. Trey Turner becomes the first out of the inning. Striding forward now is the DH, Luis Garcia, grounded out in his last at bat. First pitch is a slider, called for a strike. Liner towards second. Oh, and he misses it. A play at the plate. And now the runner from third scores to give them a very important insurance run.
Dan, that's a huge insurance run right there. Has to feel good as a hitter right there to not only get a ribby knock, but to give your team a little bit of breathing room.
It does, and it makes your pitcher go out there with a little bit more free and easy frame of mind instead of going in a 1-1 game where every pitch is so important. You're one pitch away from a solo tying the game up. That's not the case now.
Struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here.
Big pitch coming up right here. He'd love for a ground ball or a strikeout.
Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
The first baseman.
Digging in, the switch hitter, Josh Bell, who went down on strikes in his last at-bat. Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1. Trying to keep the deficit right where it is, the pitch.
You know, something to keep in mind, they're really burning through that bullpen, and this is only the first game of the series. Definitely could have an impact on the rest of the series, and maybe even the whole week ahead.
Sent on the ground out to second. Throw to first in time, and the big inning is avoided as the side is retired. So two runs on three hits, no errors, and two men left stranded. One last shot here as we go to... Brad Hand takes the mound in a safe situation as he'll try and make sure this one doesn't reach the 12th.
Brad.
So here's the potential tying run. Brett Phillips. A knock here could cut the lead to just one run.
Yeah, it's always a nightmare taking on another team's closer trying to get back into a game, especially in the ninth inning. But having your leadoff guy up to start that inning is as good as you could have hoped for. So let's see if he can get something started here.
The 0-1 delivery. Fouled away. Here it comes on nothing and two. Down the right field line. That's a fair ball. As he arrives at second without a play, as they also push across a score to make it a one-run game.
That will drive a pitching coach crazy. He has the hitter down 0-2 in the count, and instead of making him chase it something off the plate, he grooves one that's driven down the line for a run-scoring double. Have to make better pitches on an 0-2 count.
Into the box, Yandy Diaz. But he'll watch a sinker here that misses, hits ball one. A base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. Oh, and that looked like the very definition of flailing there. It's even at one.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here, so we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
Swing, high drive, left field, and deep. Gone! Santa Maria, game over! It's a two-run shot to straightaway left, and none bigger than that one as this ball game is over.
Hey, when you get into extra innings, you're always looking for that one guy to step up and be that hero. And this guy was the hero tonight. What does he do? Steps up with a walk-off home run to end this thing in extras.
Final line score for our ball game tonight for the big